I'm Alexis Van Hurkman, and welcome to Resolve in a Rush, where you'll learn DaVinci Resolve grading and finishing techniques in under 5 minutes. In this episode, we're going to see how you can move a DaVinci Resolve project from one workstation to another. And in the process, we're going to answer a question I get asked all the time, which is how you can relink media to a project in DaVinci Resolve. To start out with, I've got this project here, and to export this project and move it to another workstation, all I have to do is go to the File menu and choose Export Project. Simple enough. Go ahead and save it. I get my export dialog. And I'm going to name this Alexis Export. I'm going to stash that on my desktop. Now you have the option of saving any stills, EDLs, LUTs, or audio used within that project. I'm going to save my stills and click OK. At this point, it's time to copy this exported project and all of the media that I know it links to another workstation. After copying the project file and all of the media separately to the new workstation, I simply log in. And to import the project, I simply right-click anywhere within the project manager and I choose Import. I get my dialog and I'm going to go back to the desktop. There's Alexis Export. There it is. And of course, when I open this project up, I can see when I go to the edit page that all of my clips have gone offline. There's actually a really easy way to relink all of these clips. In fact, there are two different ways, and I'm going to show you each one. So to relink all of those clips is most easily shown in the media page. One thing I could do if I don't care about the previous structure of anything that I had in the media pool is I can go ahead and just delete all those bins. And the simplest way of relinking is for me to simply identify where those clips happen to be. In this case, they're in a directory called New Drive. And drilling down to find the proxy media that I had created before, I can simply right-click on that proxy folder and add everything inside of it to the media pool. Once I do this and go back to the edit page, you'll see that immediately Resolve is smart enough to relink everything I've put into the media pool with the corresponding clips in the timeline. So that's cool, and it's super simple if you're doing finishing and you're a colorist and you don't really care about the editorial structure of the media pool. But this is not cool if you're an editor and you actually wanted all of that organization. So starting all over again, we're going to do this a second time. I'm going to open up my project. I already have that file that I imported, and it's still unlinked because I didn't save it. So just going in here to the edit page, everything's offline. So to preserve this organization in the media pool, what I can do is I can simply select the whole group of bins. This is important because I now have to select one of those clips and press Command A to select all of the clips, because the command I want is associated with these clips, not the bins. If I right-click any clip, I can choose Change Source Folder. I can see the previously saved path for all of those files, and clicking the bottom two fields three-dot button, I can choose a new path. And I'm going to choose the top enclosing folder of everything in this project. Resolve's smart enough to drill down into subfolders. And when I click Open and then click Change, all of a sudden, everything gets relinked. But if I just jump over to the edit page, you can see that in one fell swoop, I've relinked the entire project, all of the media, and I've preserved the hierarchy of all of these bins. So I hope you found that useful. For more information on how to use DaVinci Resolve, check out the editing in DaVinci Resolve. and grading in DaVinci Resolve titles available from Ripple Training. This is Alexis Herkman. Thanks a lot for watching.